In the previous 77 episodes, we actually haven't discussed a topic which might be discussed among the climbers the most, and that's grades. Grades aren't decided by any kind of referees or judges, and there is no mathematical equation where factors like length of the route, overhang, size of the holds, the distances between the holds, the friction would come into place. It's all based on subjective feeling of the first ascensionist, alternatively on the subjective feeling of those who repeat the route. The grade is based on comparing of all the routes that I have either tried or done. Nevertheless, if you try to think about it as scientifically as possible, there are definitely a couple of factors that I take into the consideration when I give a route a certain grade. I need to consider whether it's a style that fit me, my strengths and weaknesses, how long it took me to finally climb the route. I consider if I feel fit or not.
Pokud to mě takhle bude ještě blbě, to fakt napřed můžu zapomenout.
I also consider if the conditions while I was trying a route were good or they weren't.
Protože najdou takový vedro. Mě potí pracky, jenom se kouknu na skálu.
Imagine a climb which is that vertical with razor blade crimps. If you climb it with a 30 degree heat, you should probably grade it a little bit lower than your subjective feelings, because this climb, if it will be climbed with perfect conditions, will definitely feel way easier. But when it's a super steep route with big holds, then maybe conditions are not that important. I take all of these factors into the consideration and then I try to give my honest opinion about a grade. The number. Multiple grading scales have developed all over the world. But to make it more simple, let's consider the French grading scale for sport climbing or even tread climbing and Fontainebleau grading scale for bouldering. World's first 8A happened in 1979. The world's first AB Plus happened in 1985. The first 9A happened in 1991, world's famous route Action Direct, first ascended by Wolfgang Gillig. And the first 9C happened 26 years later in 2017. As you could see, the progression went pretty fast in the 80s. Within 12 years, the grading scale jumped from 8A all the way to the 9A. But then the progression got steadily slower and slower. But the reason behind that is not that the grading scale wouldn't be linear and would be exponential. No, it is linear. It is just getting progressively harder to get better the better climber you are. Let's say that I can safely claim that I will never ever climb a 10B, because it would be just way ahead of its time. It would kind of go against all the statistical historical data that you can find here. In my point of view, and I know that this could be controversial, grade only indicates the physical difficulty and not the mental difficulty. If the route is scary or the boulder problem is super highball, the mental difficulty shouldn't really add anything to the grade at all. Let's give an example. A highball should have the same grade no matter if you top rope it or you climb it ground up. The grade should also be based on the easiest possible solution, the beta, the sequence of the movements. And that's why the grade should be based on the red point and not the onside, because it's very rare to find the best possible solution when you're climbing onside. The grade should also be the most objective for, let's say, the average person. And that means that sometimes it's not really fair for the super short climbers when the route is reachy, and sometimes it's not really fair for super tall climbers when it's really hard to get into the position when, for example, the footholds are really high. Bohemian Rhapsody and 9A Plus that I put up this spring is, for example, pretty reachy route. And I do believe that if you're lower than 170 centimeters, the route is almost impossible, no matter how hard you try to make it. The grades of the roots can change over the time. They can change because the root changed itself. Broken holds usually make the root harder. Sometimes breaking the hold can actually create a better hold, and that can actually make the root a little bit easier. Golpe de Estado is a 9B established by Chris Sharma, and I made the second ascent of it. And the story of the root is quite interesting. There's a hold that broke after the Chris made the first ascent, but it's in the upper part, which is not really the crux. It made the root a tiny bit harder when I made the second ascent, but it definitely didn't make it considerably harder in order to break it into the higher barrier, into the 9B+. So not every time the root gets actually harder, it's kind of like big difference enough to really upgrade the root. Second scenario is that there is a new technology that makes the climb easier. Some routes definitely do get way easier if you use knee pads, but the first ascensionist might not have used it because the knee pads are here frequently with us only for a few years. We should reflect this, and some routes might need a change of the grade. The climbing shoes might be the answer why all old and vertical climbs feel so hard for its grade nowadays. Because the climbing shoes back in the 80s were pretty good already for this tiny edging on the tiny footholds. Whereas when it comes to overhangs, back in the 80s, the climbing shoes, they're very bad for stuff like toe hooking or heel hooking. And that's why those rare steep climbs from the 80s or 90s feel comparatively way easier than those vertical and technical climbs and less overhanging. It's very often that also a new beta, new sequence is found. For a first ascensionist, the worst case scenario is if it gets downgraded by using the very same sequence, the very same beta with the same technology, and just simply saying that this route is way easier. That's the most embarrassing. Let's give in a few examples of how hard the climbing in some of the famous routes can look like. Chi is an 8C, relatively short rest, an 8A boulder, and still makes it a 9A+. Bohemian Rhapsody could be still an 8C, very bad rest, into a short 8A boulder, into an 8B top out. All these three maths are very different, yet still the resulted grade is 9A+. For Silence, I suggested 9C, and I had the courage to suggest this grade because it's the route that I spend the most time. On the top of that, the crux, in my opinion, really fits my style, and still it was a real struggle even when I was sending it. If I added all these factors into one, I could tell myself, yes, I have the courage to say this is the world's first 9C. By the way, huge congratulations to Alex Megos, who has just established the second 9C in the world by Bibliography in Seuss in France. La Rambla is super famous route in Catalonia in Spain, 9A+, and it climbs pumpy 30 meters of about 8C into a rest where you can stay maybe half a minute, but not any longer, into a 7C boulder problem. The crux by itself is not that difficult, but the pumpy character of the climbing before adds a lot. Grades will always be a huge source of discussions among climbers. Some climbers will always dislike it, thinking that it kind of takes the real beauty away from climbing. But I think it's just a tool. You can use it in the right way, and maybe not. In my point of view, grades can be a great indicator of how to choose the right challenge, the right route for you, or the right route to get a warm up. On the top of that, without grades, the climbing wouldn't be a sport. My recommendation is don't take the grades too seriously, always be conscious that it's just a number suggested by someone, and I do believe that in the end it helps you to have even more fun in climbing. But don't ever forget that having fun is the most important thing in climbing.